Hey everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to introduce you to the 3D motion converter tool for Cartoon Animator that allows you to convert 3D motions for your 2D characters. Please be aware that this feature is available for G3 human characters only. If you haven't created your own characters yet, you can use the embedded ones found in the Content Manager under Actor Template, Character, and G3 360 Human. In this version you will find 5 dummies with different angle profiles in the Dummy for 3D Motion folder. On each thumbnail, you'll see 2 icons on the top right. The top one indicates that the dummy has a 360 head that allows your character to simulate 3D head motion in a 2D environment. The one below that indicates that the character has a bone hand, which allows for more detailed bone-driven finger animation on the character. In this tutorial, we're going to start with this front side dummy that is positioned at 45 degrees forward. You can find your 3D motions in the Animation, Animation Template, Motion, and 3D Motion folder path. Once you apply the motions to your 2D character, the Import 3D Motion panel will pop up, and you'll see the 2D and 3D bone dummy in the same pose. If you want to break the link between the 2D character and the 3D dummy, simply click the Link Activated button at the bottom right of the panel viewport. If you close the Import 3D Motion panel, you can open it again by using the button on the left toolbar. However, now there is no animation applied. You can click and drag a motion from the library to the character, and both characters will link and pop into the initial pose. However, you'll notice that the 2D pose is slightly off when compared to the dummy. This is because the projection angle doesn't fit the 2D character, so we need to adjust this value on the slider to around negative 45 degrees. You can also simply click on the number to snap to that value. If we want the character to be able to turn the other direction, we can enable the Flip Body checkbox, and then adjust the angle to positive 45 degrees to see the result. Let's apply this walk motion to demonstrate a couple of other features of this tool. In the Motion section, you'll also see a Ground Offset slider that allows you to adjust the height of your character's hip from the ground. With this particular walk animation, the character will physically walk forward in the scene as part of the animation. When we play this motion, you'll see the 2D character walk forward. While this playback is looping, we can adjust the projection angle to see how the animation would look from those particular angles. If we want the character to stay in place and not move forward, then we can enable the Root Motion checkbox. Once we do, you'll see the character will animate in place and not move forward. There is also an option to enable Z-axis in the Body tab. If we disable this, the character will not move forward at all. If we want it to appear as though the character is moving closer towards us on the 2D plane, then we can increase the strength of this value. You'll see once we do that the character comes a lot closer to the viewer by the end of the animation loop. Let's talk about saving these 3D motions next. The first thing we need to do is select the Apply to Timeline button at the bottom of the panel. This will automatically deactivate the link between 2D character and dummy. Let's go ahead now and open the timeline. We can click and drag in the timeline to see that the motion has indeed been applied to the character's timeline in the motion track. However, our dummy character will remain stationary. We can re-enable the link again by clicking the Link Activated button, and when we do, clicking and dragging in our main timeline will have no effect. You will only be able to play back the original motion from the Import 3D Motion panel, even though the motion has already been applied. Let's drag the playhead to the end of the first clip, and then select Apply to Timeline once again. Once we do, a new clip will be created that starts at that exact position on the timeline. If we open the face tracks of our character in the timeline, we'll see that clips are also created in the facial clip track that match with the motion track. To save the motion, we need to set our end frame to the end of both of the clips, which is the area that we want to save out. Next, let's go into the Custom tab of the Content Manager, and in the Perform folder, click on the plus button at the bottom. This will create our clip, and we can then name it and right-click on it, and select Capture Thumbnail. If you want to apply 3D motions to any G3 character with different body proportions, use the newly embedded dummies in this version to convert those motions, since this allows Cartoon Animator to standardize the bone structure and get more accurate results when retargeting. Doing this allows you to apply your saved motion to any other G3 characters, as you can see here. Despite different proportions, they all perform the same walk. If you want to find more 3D motions to use in Cartoon Animator, you can go to the Content Store, where you'll find a new 3D motion section under Cartoon Animator. There are tons of great motions in various bundles here that are also available for iClone. You can also import 3D motions from other sources like Mixamo here using 3D Exchange. Once the motion is converted to Reillusion format, then you can apply it to your 2D characters the same way as was just shown. In our other 3D motion converter tutorials, we'll talk in a bit more detail about the other features of this awesome tool, but for now I'll sign off. Thanks for watching everyone, and I'll see you in the next video.